teaches story. So in fact, I postdoc with Philip in 2008, and then started my engineering career here in 2011. And so I'm also one of the many who are incredibly fortunate to have interacted with Philip. I just want to point out one thing real quick. Here is the guest book. So free to sign, leave a note. Plenty of space here. Wrong picture, I suppose. There are just people in anyway, with that, we'll move on to our next speaker. It's my great pleasure to introduce Professor John Spence from Arizona State University. In fact, that's where I did my undergrad. So, as we are a little bit of a Philip is in Colorado, contributions from the field of our state, but also in time resolve photophotography, and that's going to be the prelude to John's Spence talk today. We're going to have some really nice work that he's been doing at Arizona State. He's a X-ray free electron lasers, and with that, let's give John a nice welcome.
Additional redistribution Now, people have been out running radiation damage in various forms for decades.
We've done some very local processes. Now we can connect from you to this place. So we get pattern with 40 parameters and poles typically. And you can do my work shown here. Here's laser, which is exciting, these little protein nanocrystals, they come along in a zigzag tree in biology, of course, everything has to be wet, and it's in vacuum, so it makes life very difficult to repair. And then the protein nanocrystals continue to fly along until they're slow enough by the X-ray pulse coming along here, but not before we capture the crack pattern. And that's the pattern. Here's some hints that show the process. First, the fraction before the track, and then the name pad was the last 6 years. And here you can see in more detail the sample delivery, which is really the thing that I focus on in my lab, starting around 2004. We focused selected it down to the high speed, high gas screen here. So it's down the top. And those liquid screen turns into droplets. They freeze at about 10 degrees a second as the lysol running across the vacuum. So that's how we get the hydration which you need to study biology. And I'll just show you one result. This is really led by the Irish Smith, an incredibly energetic poker guy, as a walker. He's done the most fantastic results in two papers, one to science and another 2 years. And I'll show you just the latest working with our group and many other people. But main Marius mastermind is observation of this is transferization reaction in photoreceptor yellow protein YP. But the remarkable thing is time resolution. Because he's now down at about, well, the OCLS briefest pulses you can play a 10 femtoseconds. And of course the divine period is about 100 femtoseconds. So it's a tenth of the vibrational period of that. So the resolution here is about 200 femtoseconds. And that's fast enough to freeze the motion of a protein absorbing a photon. This is the same mechanism as transphosphorylation, which goes back to Pasteur and sadly to thalidomide too, which is the wrong isomer. But it's the response of the protein to bind. And that's the same reaction on retina, the back of your eye. So this is, in a sense, the first event in human vision. And the third thing is the yellow protein. And it consists of a rotation about a bond, and all chemistry students is called a torsion angle here, 140 degrees in the trans state, and 39 state, so rotated here. And the chance of us to see this bang for a molecular movement. It's not really a movie, and that's a long story we'll talk about. It's complicated by photonic conception. Also, the interesting and useful that we don't find your interest. But here's the result. Two orthogonal projections along the top, one projection, another projection below. Each column here is a different time interval. This time interval, of course, is as Bill works with the delay and the time probe. And we take lots of shots in each delay because our crystals are tunneling across the beam, random rotation. We have to convert the data to get one three-dimensional reconstruction for each delay. So here is the time for each of these running up to 3 seconds, something about 150 seconds. Now, the distance rotation occurs only at about 550 seconds. To the right is therefore shown green, and to the left is sort of orange color. And it's a rotation about this axis here that I've shown dotted, the bond axis. The rotation occurs when this is complete by the time you get to this on the line here. So you follow that series across there, and you can see this in the 3D maps clearly. And in fact, the main move is where you can also see how. That's remarkable because of time resolution. And again, we're outrunning radiation damage. To understand the weak electrodynamics, this really has no scientific content whatsoever, this power. It just sort of indicates that I started working on a vaccine data to model this in electrodynamics. There are two reaction paths, so when you think about it, it's pretty complicated. It is crystals for which you detect a fracking, time point. The free kind of molecules are those who do nothing because the probability of their station is low, quantum excitation. There are those who follow this reaction path, and others who follow the second reaction path. And you have this angle that is data analysis. And it depends on doing the process of timing. Back in the early 90s, I guess, with the single atom decomposition. So we know structure becomes the other side of structures. And I'm very accurate in previous crystallography. And there's a certain amount of modeling that is needed. And here our inlets, my lab, and the polar, to model this with molecular dynamics. Okay, the third point I wanted to mention is the interruptible response from Henry Chapman. Working with Ed Frommel and you and my group, knows that the direction pattern we're getting in LCLS from photosystem 2 has models of diffuse scattering. And this is a really fantastic thing. Here in the brackets, what you're seeing there is a slice out of the 3D verge of the data. These are thousands and thousands of these 3 feet, 25 second snapshots, indexed, merged to the 3D, and then a slice taken on the pumps and under the pumps. But beyond the bright spots, there's also the diffuse scattering, and surprisingly, it's structured and it's not isotropic. Now, we can talk about a little bit of that. There's a lot for you, but let me try and make it very clear. If we imagine there were just one molecule of primitive cell and took the free transfer of that, it would predict the form of the diffuse scattering. It is very nice. In other words, the diffuse scattering is the single particle that people have been trying to record the original molecule with three electron lasers. So, what you conclude? The only reasonable conclusion is that a form of this order is possible for the diffuse scattering is static displacement of the original molecule. That is, a protein reacting like rigorous, and they're all slightly displaced from the ideal lattice. And then take a snapshot. We average over snapshots in the computer, and that's analogous to the time averaging that we do for the CW stores. Now, what we'll look at that are rotation inputs, and it does eventually smear out here, presumably when you're starting to see effects or change in the digital placement. But the fact that this is physically calculated for a molecular transport, one more. Tells the static displacement, which astonishingly has not really been considered. There's a lot of work on the scanning proteins, but normally one thinks about in terms of correlated motion at the moment within the molecule or correlated from molecule to molecule. But static displacements haven't been considered much, even going back to the 60s, and it does depend on us. And it does two things for us. Firstly, it extends resolution. We get another angstrom. That's very important because one of the aims in our biological consortium is to image the water splitting event, but it's very important. It makes life possible on Earth and makes the oxygen we breathe, of course. So we'd like to make a movie of water splitting, but you can only do that with photosystem 2 if it does it for all plants on and animals on Earth, which is famous for making very bad crystals. So it becomes bad crystals which give us better resolution because they have this pleasure. So it may be that the form of the disorder which happens to carry photos who we don't have generally is another frame will save us and give us resolution we need to image the water we need. So it gives us the resolution. And the second thing, of course, is going back to say in 1951, the continuous scattering between the brackets possible. Solve phase problem. So in this lecture paper, led by a very capable student, Carter Gardner from Cornell, where we worked with my Delta, they both used the diffuse scattering to address the phase problem, phase, and also to extend the resolution by angstrom. So there's no chance to do that. Go back to what we looked at by 1940 earlier on. Here's by 1 year after Bragg's paper. We've engaged the theory of Bragg scattering from vibrating atoms. And of course, everybody knows that what you get is the atomic transfer.
immunoscape multiplied by 1 minus a gamma. So it's a direct response along the complementary rise of the immunoscape. And that's just what we're seeing in that pattern, except that it's isomeric, a single atom in the primitive cell, like a proton. But instead of a single atom, it's a bias theory of 13. I put a molecule, it's not a spherical, you get exactly the same result. You get two scatterings and two tracks in one molecule. And this is what it's consistent. Okay, that's the content of the statement that we came out months ago. Without using the two scattering, we have 4.5 angstrom operative group. And we included the case of 3.5. So we have about an angstrom group in the movement. So the race is not now to see how general it is. It may be a copy of a membrane protein like this one. I think it's been seen in one other system now. But of course, if you scan, it's had a long history of study in the protein. So what's the advantage of using an egg cell rather than synchrotron for this blog? We didn't realize when we started just how bad a source of egg cell is because blog is a terrible source. All these years of trying to make synchrotron stable have really paid off. This neutron has a 15% variation intensity if you're not shot. And if you put some laser, that's the last thing you want, but it's a fantastic one to map. I think we can try to keep this group by showing it and make, you know, getting the data out of the machines. No one's really succeeded in that. But there are lots of problems, and if you have to use what Mike Rossman called the American method of shoot first, ask the question later, as far as sample delivery goes, so you take patterns and then you try to mix them and figure out your orientation, rather than setting up orientation on going on with it. All these things should make the accuracy work. But the one thing it has, which is very exciting, is that because we are rather initiative damage, we don't need to cool samples to avoid damage. And therefore, we hope to get data under physiological conditions. That can be very small, which means that the correct energy is available. Your physiological process is very actively stimulated in temperature, our bodies, for example, and reaction, chemical reactions double in range for every 10 degrees to change temperature. And a lot of these electric machines, and drivers, for example, need both energy from maintaining pain to other energy, depending on drivers. Plus, the number of fluctuations, KT, and you need right thermal fluctuations to see what this molecular machine is really doing, rather than the artifacts that can be introduced in freezing and tracking experiments. So we can work at room temperature, that's the main point, and hope to see what's really going on. So, what are the processes that you can't figure out with? And I think there's work on right domain. Proteins are not optimistic, so that you can trigger a process with them. That's called optogenetics. But another way to go is to make a competing cell where you make two chemicals and make snapshots. And I'd like to talk about that for a minute. What we've been trying to do, this is an update with a long history. Yes, Moyo, Louise Johnson, I think, found the first to show the headlines of the main active. And it was seen to always be a pioneer of value method for protein, where you have huge beta cells, an absolute nightmare of overlap react, reflects as a result, and it almost shaped with an early pioneer. So, how do mixing some work with an X-ray like that's the challenge. I put a student on that back a few years ago, Digi Wang. We come to this gadget to do the sample delivery. It's like a telescope. And the idea was that in the case of an enzyme substrate, we would bring the substrate liquid in here, the little nanocrystals. Now, we're going to use crystals to get a microdilution. But then the substrate has to find its way through all the water channels in the crystals. For those who are not in proteins, it's common for brown crystals to have up to 50% more water. So the whole crystal is like a whole cheese, the channel of waterway running through it. confusion time the principles are different from those solutions. But that can work. The point is that because we have such tiny crystals, that diffusion time is small. And if you calculate it with this slight solving the heat equation, for a cube of lysozyme, it takes about 70 microseconds for glucose to permeate through the whole crystal. And we can call it a mixing time. The requirement to make a molecular fluid then is that the mixing time should be short compared to the time the chemical reaction takes. But the time solution is limited by this mixing time. So the idea is that the substrate comes around here and mixes through the crystal by starting reaction. It reacts for a time as it goes down here, and we then take our excess snapshots and the rock that's come out here, the partially reactive species in the crystal. Then if you pull this into back away to a new position, you'll get a different reaction time. Now, to measure the time response of such a device, we press a dye down the center and then a quenching agent in the out jacket. Then image it, and you see here how the fresh dye has been killed off by about this distance. So if we know the flow region here, we can figure out the time before the dye is quenched. And that gives us the timing for the reaction. So we're trying to image chemical dynamics by an extra snapshot. We outrun quench reaction. Well, this thing sort of worked, but not very well. And so we've had three beam times trying to get it out. The first two were pretty much completely disaster. The last one, we did get some results, and I'll show you one now. This a better version, because what happens in universities is you get this thing to this stage and it's too pleased, and it probably stops. You know, that book blows a hot Cornell over. My students went up there for 3 quarters and we know. He's made much better one with George Calvin. And that device, well, the next thing that happened was I got a grant for a 3D printer from the NIH, and that is a wonderful thing. It's a new photon device, nanoscribe, and that thing has very high resolution, 0.1 of a micron. Normal 3D printers sort of part of the 10th of a micron. And with that, we are now making a new generation of mixing devices. So I think it's a very exciting area, and it should go ahead. Here's the first result for mixing experiment in the old space. And it's a fully mixed stage of the reaction. This is called beta-lactam, that is. That's an enzyme that is converts antibiotic resistance to the beta-lactam antibiotics. So it prevents working. And there in the proposals. So it's very important to prevent this beta-lactamase thing from doing its job. And that's done with a drug, which is called CEF. So what we're doing here is reacting the drug molecule, and it's shown in the black box here is a reopening reaction, and in the circuitry realization over here, it's the same as that rotation. So this is beta-lactamase, and this is the fully reacted drug onto where the drug species was introduced by the sensing device and it would take snapshots during reaction. It's cetriaco, it's the name of the drug. And here are the main constants of that reaction, so it's minus 1.2 seconds. So we have one result for fully mixed, and no, 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 and as I say, the time resolution compared to the optimal work is all cleared out by the initial reaction time and the time it takes the molecules to produce the crystals. These times compared to films or something like that, crystals, the chemistry process is very long, and they're long for many reasons. Probably it's different than chemistry because the entry term in the energy is big. If it's not really spread rubber band, it hurts your fingers because it's searching for the macro state of the large number of microstates. And that takes a while, particularly in a protein because it's severe. So also solution chemistry wants the molecules to find each other before they react. So for all those reasons, it's a bit like an oil refinery or something. You're not watching one small the enabler to make the space become the governor. So I think this is a future of this work. I see the next sort of 7 years of our export consortium, which is intended as developing novel treatment mechanisms, which I've cited as here, and phrase use temporary to generate new information and try to dismantle the data and the application molecules and other possibilities. Okay. I just want to show you a little bit of this toothpaste that the human last minute a day as you.
Serious goal, and it looks, or at least, well, genuinely thinks it will be possible.
particularly once we get the traction of an upgrade. This is the editor will sweep the world in the next few years, where on his mainline he was spent about a factor of 10, that is, a thousand places around the cluster of a factor of 1,000 increasing in density, which will come, and then also by focusing on the main number of smaller size, he can get another factor of 10. When both of those factors of 10 increase, he thinks he can do anything that's a single star in a single dot node, which of course will be protected and also forth. I think my main message is that we focused on the laser, but in the process, unexpectedly, and an anticipated benefit that we had planned on was a lot of our techniques that have been taken over and secret from. How to make a painting with an extra laser is a challenge with which Pete's worked on, no one succeeded in that. It's a laser, it's not correct, that's not what you want to understand work. I'll end up fast and see how I'm doing right on time. I was going to say there's a new field of electron fraction from probing microcrystals now, or micro-UV. I just have one comment, we've done a calculation, which is called the long scattering effect. What is large crystal you can look at before you start to get a long scattering problem? I just want to say that the patterns must have radial symmetry. And if they don't, you've got long scattering, so you can't use them. It's that simple. And all bringing them not interest symmetric because of the helicity. And if they're not long scattering, then the chances don't come in real pair, and the day is worth it. That tells you you've come from the large crystal you've used, which is big enough so you lose real symmetry, then you have to throw out the data. And you know, I think everyone covers the electron diffraction very much. Last publish, real pair of tests. If this is the network that's provided, I'd say a okay, final comment. We are making an extra laser today as you. It's a compact design. Here's the building part we made. Here's the intro. It's a little braid we've hired from David Lunch group at MIT. He's on the back of the minor part now. This is what the new building will look like. First one will be the next year. This thing was 6 billion instead of 600 million in the LSLS. And that's because of the following thing. The wiggly electrons, instead of using magnets, 10 centimeters apart, 1 centimeter apart, we use a laser, a light laser, coming from any parallel electrode. And the electric field of the laser wiggles the electron. Now, in a wiggler, the X-ray wavelength is equal to the magnetic period over the energy of the electron beam, m squared. On the synchrotron, the magnets can be 1 to 10 centimeters apart, and the electron beam is a GeV. What we do if we wiggle with a laser is to take the wiggle period from 10 centimeters down to a micron wavelength of light, and therefore, to get the same 1 from X-rays wavelength, we can bring electron to the energy. 25 MU. That brings the cost, size, and the thing right down by factor of 100. So, reducing the beam energy and reducing light for wiggle electrons makes the same wave of X-ray, and because of the reduced amount of electron energy, it becomes more or less a tabletop machine. And the mechanism is the inverse complement. I wanted to mention one last project, probably one or two minutes, sorry, it's called crystal resistance. Crystal resistance, I think, is a fantastic thing. I would say, a few years ago, we asked ourselves the question in my lab, could we use a crystal as a material? Here's the idea. If you have a fast electron beam running through a crystal, and it comes out of its path as it buzzes through a crystal, and the buzz is the frequency of the X-rays emitted. It's called coherent proton. So the frequency is just the speed of the electron divided by the distance between atoms and its path. Now, atoms and its path along the crystal planes, and their spacing is dAKL. So we index these coherent emission lines. It's a very That's what I wanted to mention. And his experimental results, we got in my lab a few years ago, these here are very much about the lines. They're from a diamond crystal. Now here is the electron beam passing through diamond. These are the higher of the layers of the line, number 3 equals 0, 2. Now it happens because of the diamond space between the diamond, the equals 2 layers of reflections are all 0 in the space between the diamond. And so it is when you look at the X-ray emission lines, there is no X-ray emission line for n equals 2. This peak here is not a fact of the detector. This is a little bit of silicon taking together the peak of the detector. There's no peak here, and there's also no peak for n equals 6, I think. Yeah, 2 and 6 are all factors. It is a quick coefficient with a charge density along the path. Some of those coefficients, because the half series are 0. And so you get emission lines that are completely coherent. And now I have this contributes extra emission line to those other crystal planes, the same crystal to make layers of light atmosphere. This crystal plane also is cavity. That didn't work. But this work, and I think it's fascinating, that the cryptographic emission line, if you send sharp particles into a glass, you get French trouble. If you now order those atoms, take glass, and just move atoms into a crystal glass, the Bremsstrahl piles into a piece, one for every space in the crystal, back space in the crystal, and they're monochromatic. Okay, I'm done. Here is the X-Firex from Consortium. It's a 10-year run from the NSF to about 8 universities. Half of our PIs in green here. We want to report with them as a structural biologist. The other half of them is in red. I'm in for people. We have annual conference, we have data analysis workshop. And if you want to use an extra laser to work, please just send me an email, because our job is basically to help people who want to do that. And I'm trying to say that I think it's a better job, but it is the opportunity to work on a very temporary kind of physiological condition and get a very high time. Okay, thank you very much, Bill. And I'll just remind you what Chris said about his time. Well, nothing is more like your job, but I'm retired. What is that you've been doing for the last 10 years? They did say that all that is needed, families for happy life, is a project you are enthusiastic about. This is a deep and profound truth. So my advice is please write another book. Thank you.
Thank you. Don't show them this is master and he is like now and we are refining our masculinity on the system. I like that generation was combining real momentum space density and presently
my wife is coming, and she decided to come here at the conference.
time and the lifestyle of
data science is of course the boom of the chip of machines and the degree of available machines. The resource state is the view. Everything designed by us is us. As also does the rest of the component, and the standard of focusing on is all of these tasks. Because people asking us, what are you doing? And these are real choices. And also, it was was like a partner by passing where to focus the respective audience. And also, along with the feedback of was teaching us how to be able to use those skills that are part of the mix. And someone was very able to understand. So I didn't need the partners. Yeah, and while we also introduced the land, it was a concept, it was impossible to take the company, but it was also possible to take the company. And the size of good lesson we had from it to be the leader. But at the very end, we can be recognized to be a large part of the fact and what is also very high on my mind, he took that up in the past, and for him, and said, okay, I'm going to put the last and put it for me. And so it's about the things that we have been done.
But that's why I understand it could have
design and policy control strategies. I get to the philosophy in this way. We closely think a lot to the policy and look at advocacy, also as a new leadership and fiscal balance.
These are very nice studies, but in which they
And then if I raise the wave to tell the scope so that the hose is within the set of the wave, using the bottom wave from the time to the zero cast density of the 1 kilobyte mark, then I can write on the next to the solid component into which the scope is so small. And it is here that this is
the
Is the dancing fox, as said,
The result of this is of
And you will see that intelligence is the magnetic part and this resolution is also correct. But that is the realization
and